It all.
Wish you the same, doctor.
Great to see all today. So the motto should be independent always at any age.
That's very true.
Happy Independence Day. All the best.
Hey, bye.
So, we are tackling a very good, very important issue today, and that is medications, because medications are something which if a lot of older people don't have, then that is a blessing in disguise. But then a lot of times you have to have medications and they can become multiple as well. So managing these multiple medications is very important. So how do you work around medications? There are several steps that you can take. Before that, Now we have to understand that the medications actually work very differently as far as older people are concerned. And how do they work? What is the different ways that it actually works? One is you have to realize that the body, obviously, it changes as far as organs are changing. They age. Then there is obviously changes in the breakdown and the body composition as we age. So the medication works differently. Now the effectiveness and the side effects of the medications will be affected by not only the diseases and conditions that develop, but the medicines themselves. So basically the interactions could be medicines among medicines, medicines among your aging body, and also your diseases. So there are multiple interactions. Now, what are the changes which in the body which usually happen? And the medications obviously will be effective if, one, they have to be absorbed into the body. So that happens due to your stomach and intestines. Then it is distributed where it is needed. Then it is broken down and ultimately eliminated. Most medications are eliminated through the urine. Now, the age-related changes in the body can obviously affect the dosage. So that's why we always believe in starting on a lower dose as far as older people are concerned, and then go higher, because some medications that can be useful in younger adults can have more harms in older adults. So we have to be very careful. When taking the medications, the following factors are very important. One is the correct medication being prescribed for the correct condition? Two is the medication right for you and your condition? And third is, are you taking the proper dose for the length of the time? So basically your healthcare provider has told you, but you are not been able to take. Then another thing that we commonly that occurs is multiple medications, multiple medical conditions. Now an older adult unfortunately might not have only one disease, it might have 1+1+1. So there might be lots, and they might affect how the various medications are absorbed, broken down, eliminated. For example, older adults have memory problems, might actually have worse memory, behavioral problems, and even sleep problems caused by medicines which are given for other conditions. So then these interactions are very important. Then effects of food and beverages on the medications. Now, medications can also get affected by food, beverages, for example, taking two medications together. Like antibiotics will not be absorbed with certain medications. For example, if you take with calcium, magnesium, iron. So antacids and iron, if taken together, will cancel each other out. Then the issue is you might be taking the medicine, but the medicine does not work and the medicine just builds up in your body. Then medication interactions. Now an older adult who might be on medications for other conditions in addition to a new one. So now this result happens is other medicines are there and then a new one is added. So we'll have to see what interaction that the new medication will have with the other medications. And then some might slow down the breakdown of the medications, others might speed up. So we have to be very careful. Then other factors. Now, a medication can get affected, of course, with changes in diets, with infections. Now, common side effects which we are worried about in older adults can be falls, then imbalance, sudden weight loss, weight gain, and of course, memory changes. Now, unfortunately, these are the ones which can contribute to increased frailty, increased weakness, lesser amount of endurance, and difficulty in ability to do day-to-day life. Then polypharmacy. Now polypharmacy is very, very important. Many older adults cope with more than one medical condition. So it becomes difficult for managing these medical conditions. And for managing these medical conditions, you have multiple medications. Now, for example, if an older adult takes more than 5 or more medications, it's actually known as polypharmacy. Now, the polypharmacy can be an issue because all these medications would interact with each other and might interact with your body in harmful ways. Now, for example, a medication can increase the negative side effects or it can decrease the desired effects. Now, it's very important that we know that multiple medications should not be prescribed unless it is needed. There is something known as essential polypharmacy also. For example, if you have multiple diseases, then you might have to take those multiple medications. Now, it's very, very important that you tell all your healthcare providers. Maybe sometimes you are not only going to one doctor, you're going to many, about all the medications you're taking, no matter who has prescribed what. Because sometimes what happens, this is where the medications are missed. Especially vitamins, supplements, over-the-counter medications. These are something sometimes older adults do not express unless they are asked. Then it is our job for you to figure out that whether these drugs need to be stopped or these drugs need to be continued. Now, if you have had unwanted symptoms like dizziness, history of fall, memory problems, then you should tell us because then we will obviously try to alter the medication. So there's another thing which is known as prescribing cascade. Sometimes, unfortunately, medications you are taking might actually have new symptoms, or they can make these already symptoms which are there worse. Now, this can lead to a prescription cascade. For example, a medicine side effect is there and a medication is mistaken for a new condition. So the healthcare provider will give another medication for that. Now, this will lead to more medications being provided for more side effects. So we as healthcare providers always tell you what side effects will be there of that particular medication. And before you get any new medication, if one of the medications you're already taken is causing you a side effect, you should be telling your healthcare provider, because accordingly we'll be doing. Prescription cascade can be very difficult to arrest once it's started, because then we have to stop all the medications, wait whether the side effects subside, and then only the person will improve. Now, medications that old adults should avoid or use with caution. Now, these include a large number of diseases. For example, medications and type of medications that are inappropriate. So there are certain medications which can be inappropriate and should be replaced. Then there are inappropriate with certain health conditions. For example, if we give too much of sedatives to a person with Parkinson's disease, then the Parkinson's disease can obviously get more worsened and the person can get disoriented also. Now, there are certain medications which have to be used with caution in older adults. Now, these, and we always have to have a balance between benefits and harms, because and the best choice has to be given to the older adult. Now, a list of medication combinations is also important, which may result in drug-to-drug interaction. So, there are some combination of medications and classes which shouldn't be given together. Then there are a lot of older adults who have poor kidney function. So we might have to change their medications or alter their medications depending upon their kidney function. So what is important is there are certain lists which we use, which of course is for our benefit. What should older adults do to lower the chance of medication related problems? Please always keep a list of all the medications you take. By all, I mean all, both non-prescription. This includes any supplements whatsoever, like vitamins. Please write down all the doses and always bring the list when you look at the doctor. Now, the reason I am saying is we can check the medications immediately. Ideally, you should also try to bring a strip of the medications or a medication pill box itself, so that we can see if these are the side effects. And immediately, if at all we are trying to start a new medication, we can keep that in mind, or we can stop the current medications which are causing you problems. Then we should always ask to the healthcare provider, in spite of him or her telling you that what medication side effects can cause. If you think a medication is not working, then you should also tell your healthcare provider as soon as possible. There is no use of taking a medication for long which is not working. Then it's very important that you share with your healthcare provider any kind of side effects which you have at any point with any medications. Now, another important thing is alternative remedies. Now, a lot of older adults might be taking alternative remedies as well. It is very important that when we take herbal, when we take natural, when we take Ayurvedic, when we take homeopathic medications, we should know whether what kind of interactions they might have with or side effects they might have with other kinds of medications. And the side effects can be much, much serious because you have to imagine the interaction is not only between the homeopathic medication and the allopathic medication. It is between the homeopathic medication and the body and the aging changes. So the interactions can be very, 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 very hazardous. Now, another mistake is that large doses of vitamins or minerals is safe. This is not always the case. We should not be taking too many minerals and too many vitamins as well. For example, too much of vitamin A can worsen your bone health. So it is very, very important that we take things in amount and not too much. Please always, whenever you tell your healthcare providers, tell about any alternative remedies or any over-the-counter medications that you are taking, so that we are able to know whether they have any issues or they can cause side effects, or we can talk to your healthcare provider who has been prescribed that, so that we can actually discuss those medications, and if there is a way it can be stopped, we should stop. Then another important thing is what you can do, ultimately what you can actually do to manage your medication, which I think is the most important thing. See, there are several steps that you can use. One is always make a list. I mean, I'm reiterating on it because you should know. I mean, ultimately, they are chemicals. You are taking those chemicals. So you should know what all medications you're on, whether it's prescription or non-prescription. These should include any and all medications, including your supplementations, including your herbal, including your Ayurvedic, including your oils. You should also ideally write down the doses and remember to bring the list. And also, if possible, if photographs are there of the particular strips, then okay. Or if you can bring the strips, then better. If you're not able to write it down yourself, then you should take the help of the If you have any doubts, please ask immediately what should it be taken with, what should it not be taken with. That is also very, very important. Then the potential for medication interactions. So can these medicines cause interactions with other medicines? So that is also something you should look out for. Then side effects. Most healthcare providers will tell you, for example, these medications have these side effects. So you need to watch out for that. If you have had any kind of reaction to a medication and you think a medication is not working, you should tell. Sometimes not all medications will be okay for everybody. So a side effect, an allergy might happen. So you should always mention either in your paper or you should know that these are the medications you are allergic to. Again, do not stop taking a medication without checking with your healthcare provider, or do not start a medication without checking with your healthcare provider, because these are ultimately, again, now I'm saying these are chemicals which can have side effects. Then always ask about the over-the-counter medications, because these are the ones which you might get without the doctor's prescription. So if you are going to be taking anything, please ask your doctor. Please ask your doctor whether there are side effects for the same, because over-the-counter medications can make your condition very, very bad. For example, if you're taking any painkillers for any knee pain, any back pain, and you're not told at all, and later you realize you're actually having a kidney problem, that is not worth it. And you should always know the correct dose of a over-the-counter drug as well. Everything is doses. So you cannot just take a medication and then, realize that you overdosed it. If you're hospitalized, always review the medications very, very, it has to be reviewed. The hospital team, of course, will be responsible for giving you the medicines you need. Again, do not take any medications on your own during your hospital stay. And if at all there are new medications that have been added, then of course you'll be explained regarding the same. Also look out for any inappropriate medications. Then take your medications properly. Now, sometimes what happens is older adults might not understand, or they're not clear on how to take medications. And there are difficulties. For example, difficulty in reading and understanding the directions which are there in the medication box. Print might be too small. Directions might be unclear. Then sometimes trouble opening the medicine containers, pouring medications, or even taking a glass of water. So here, the caregiver's role becomes very, very important. Then sometimes what happens, healthcare providers do not provide enough information about the importance of taking medications. So medications to treat conditions with no obvious symptoms such as blood pressure or diabetes. So we as healthcare providers will also be telling you or reassuring you about the particular safety and side effects of these medications, especially if they are newly prescribed medications. Now, you should never worry about telling the healthcare provider that they have not been taking medications or you have not been following directions. Of course, you might feel that no, the healthcare provider might say why you are doing that. But it is very important that you take it, because any doubts that you have regarding your medications, you should be clearing then and there. Or if later you have doubts, you should get in touch. Because if you're having any trouble taking your medication, please discuss it immediately and we will always try to give you a very easy solution to that. Now also, there is usually also a pharmacist in every hospital, and they usually try to describe to you that how and when you should actually take your medications with instructions. So that is something which is very, very important. Now there is usually a my drug and supplement diary in which you can just, for example, what all you can write. You can write your name, you can write your phone number, then healthcare provider, any known allergies, and then you can write your current medications and supplementations. For example, name of the drug, what dose you are taking, and also when you have been taking these medications. Then there are, of course, certain questions that you should be keeping in mind when you might visit the geriatrician as far as medication management is concerned. For example, what does the label on my medication tell me if the print is not very clear? You can ask, what does the medication actually do? Then, are all my medicines necessary? I've been taking them for years. Can something be cut down? I have started a medication. How long will it take to start working? Then, when do I experience a new symptom? Then, do I have to mention all the medications, including my non-prescription medications? Yes. Then to the pharmacy also, you might get certain medications over the counter, but you have to be vigilant. Then, if at all you are using only one pharmacy, it will be good because he will be knowing your medicines. Of course, sometimes you have to don't get medicines and you have to visit different pharmacies. Now, there are a lot of ways you can remind yourself for medications. One is, of course, the pill box where you can actually put the timings and the day when you have to say. Then there are applications also in the phone which actually do give you reminders. Then if you miss a dose, please do not double up the dose yourself. Please inform your your healthcare providers that you have missed the dose and what should you do, because sometimes double the dose might not work at all and it might be actually more dangerous. Then food items. You might actually have to ask your healthcare provider whether food items will be interacting with your drugs. Then even vitamins react with other drugs, so don't think that vitamins are just something which are totally harmless. Then storage of medications, that is something you need to ask a healthcare provider and your pharmacist. For example, insulins, for example, specific medications should not be stored in hot areas. Then another thing is how to stay healthy as possible. Even if you are taking all the medications, remember the medications are not the ones which are keeping you healthy. It is your overall health that is keeping you healthy. So you need to continue doing your exercise. You need to continue taking a healthy diet. You need to manage all your conditions. So that was an overview on how to take all your medications and how to manage multiple medications. Thanks a lot for your patient hearing. If you have any questions, then you can obviously ask.
Thank you very much, Dr. Prem. In case anybody wants to ask questions, please unmute yourself. Only those who are asking questions, unmute yourself. I think we have time for about 3 to 4 questions. Any questions?
Usually, ma'am, vitamins are usually taken after the food only. And sometimes if you have multiple vitamins, then of course, for example, specifically if it is for the eye conditions or is it for other conditions, then of course you might have to time it out. Usually, if you have lesser number of pills, then it's good. If you have more number of pills, we try to space it out rather than you have to take one or two pills together. But of course, it's not that all the medications, they sort of interact with each other. But usually if you have multiple medicines, for example, if you have three pills to take at the same time, we say that usually take it one afterwards rather than actually taking it together. Because a lot of older people actually take it together. Then certain medications have specific instructions, like if you are taking a medication like an antacid, then you need to take it half an hour before food. And then you need to make sure that you need to eat. Then, for example, if you are taking a medication for diabetes, and you're not eating food, then there is a great chance that your sugars will go down. These are specific instructions which really matter.
Thank you.
Any other questions for the doctor? So doctor, can I ask you one? Actually, one question divided into two parts. When we're talking about different streams of medicine, allopathy, homeopathy, Ayurveda, let's say that as a patient, I'm having all three. Do I need to tell my allopathic doctor that I'm having the following medicine in homeopathy, following medicine in Ayurveda? Most of the time, I don't even know what I'm having. I just have those pills. So what do I do there?
And yeah, so I think
my second question linked to this is, do allopathy medicines, homeopathy medicines, and Ayurvedic medicines taken in conjunction cause me any harm?
See, as far as your healthcare providers are concerned, I would say the most important thing is that if all the faculties which are involved, whether it's Ayurvedic, whether it's allopathic, and whether it's homeopathic, is actually working for your betterment, then it's not an issue. The biggest issue with happens is with quacks, because a lot of people actually take advantage and they give some medications which are absolutely not warranted. So that is what the risk happens. Now, as far as telling your medications is concerned, yes, you should. To be very frank, if you ask me, my knowledge of Ayurvedic and homeopathic medications, it might not be perfect. But that's not the point. The point is, if you tell me that you're taking these medications, at least I'll be able to discuss with your Ayurvedic and homeopathic doctor that these are the medications I am giving. And we can actually discuss whether there would be actually an interaction with the same. It's not about just shunning and saying, no, you should not take the Ayurvedic medicines completely, or you should not take the homeopathic medications completely. Ideally, not mixing them is good, purely because there has not been real trials. If you see, there is not much research which goes on where people are taking both the medications and we are able to see that, no, these are the side effects or these are the interactions. Now, more and more, especially since this government has come in, more and more people are actually, that the Department of Ayush has conducted a lot of trials as far as Ayurvedic medicines are concerned. So as we get more and more research, we are able to know the safety of these medications. Now, as far as harm and this is concerned, as I told you, the second question I answered first, is that until unless the healthcare provider is certified and he is actually able to explain to you that these medications might interact or might not, then it's okay. The real issue happens with quacks, because ultimately sometimes they are giving medications which are very heavy on metals, like Ayurvedic medications, and that can lead to neuropathies, that can lead to muscle problems. Then certain times even steroids are given. Steroids are magic drugs. I mean, if you give steroids, then everything seems to be okay. But then they are giving in doses which are really bad. And then people come back with diabetes and other issues and other muscle problems. So that's why it's always better that you frankly tell that these are the medications you're taking. And yeah, I agree with you. Sometimes the medicines names and all, even the patient does not remember. They are like, just, I'm just taking this Ayurvedic medication. Like certain medications do not have interactions, like we very well know. For example, there are certain churans, there are certain liquids which are there for the digestion and that's there for constipation. So what I have seen is they really do not have much of side effects as compared with when we are taken with allopathic also. But then when you're talking about proper oral medications and all the kriyas that is done, I mean, it's very difficult for me to say whether they'll have interactions. But yeah, I have seen cases where people have taken Ayurvedic medications and their contents have been totally wrong and they have been quacks and ultimately they have had developed more problems than improvement.
Thank you very much, doctor. Anybody else has any questions? The doctor, we're actually going to... Oh, sorry. Somebody's coming in.
The doctor, when we go to a pharmacist or something and sometimes the medicine that we ask for is not available. So sometimes they suggest this is the alternative, acha hai, le lo type of a thing. So what do you suggest in such cases? Whether that would be appropriate, right one to have?
No, I would say it depends on the content. For example, if you are going to buy a Crocin and he doesn't have a Crocin and he tells you that no, you can take a Dolo, so the content is still paracetamol. So that is something which can still be taken. But there have been instances where similar drugs have been prescribed wrongly, similar sounding drugs. That's why if you're going to take any over-the-counter drugs and the pharmacist says, aap ye le lo, I think a quick call to your GP or your whoever, your doctor, would always be ideal to say that, can I take these medications? Mostly where we have seen is we do not involve our doctors when we are taking over-the-counter drugs. We usually don't. We do not even ask them. So it would be better actually to still ask them purely because, I mean, for example, give me some mere ko ek painkiller de do. Now, over-the-counter painkillers should not be given anyways, but you get it. And then if a paracetamol is not available and then you are given something like a diclofenac, that can actually cause more harm to your kidneys without you knowing. So in that case, you should be very careful before taking that. Even if you buy it, please do not take it without clarifying from your healthcare provider. And if he or she says no, then you should obviously return and take whatever is prescribed, because ultimately that is very, very, very important. Because a lot of cases have been seen where people have just taken over-the-counter drugs and we realize for years together, and it's ailments which matter a lot. For example, knee pain, back pain, and painkillers have been taken over-the-counter for years together, and then they unfortunately arrive with very bad kidney problems, kidney injuries, and then it's unfortunately too late. So that's why one has to be very careful.
Thank you, doctor.
Any other questions for the doctor?
Excuse me. Do the healthcare providers give so much of time explaining you that you should have, if you are taking these three kinds of medicine, this will go affect this, this might affect this. And do they I have to ask every time I have to call up my healthcare provider, that means a doctor, to... I don't think they give so much of time.
That is where, as far as I am concerned, I do that, because I think drugs are very important. Drugs are one of the most important parts as far as elderly are concerned and geriatrics are concerned. And all I can say is, if your healthcare provider is busy for that particular time, I'm sure that he or she will reply to you later, because it's a very valid sort of question, because these are ultimately going to interact with your body. And see, for me, the drug review part's a very important part of my consultation, purely because ultimately I can delete or add only if I know the drugs. And yes, explaining side effects, explaining thing is very, very important. So for those healthcare providers who might not have the time, there is always somebody else. So what we as geriatricians also do, we try to do work in a multidisciplinary way, wherein if we are not able to say everything, there will be a pharmacist who will be trying to help you out, because they know the side effects, they know everything, and they will also inform us. So ultimately, it's sort of making sure that there is a chain and you are told about that. Because what happens is, treating side effects becomes another headache completely. And then prescribing medications, withdrawing medications, the drug-to-drug interactions and drug side effects become very, very difficult to manage in any person, actually, an older person more so. So, yeah, I mean, if you're saying that everybody might not have the time, yeah, but ultimately it is a job of a healthcare provider to facilitate it, that if they are not able to do it, at least somebody would. For example, when you're discharged from a hospital, the nurse and usually the pharmacist actually tells you all the medications in spite of the doctor having told. Because I also, before the discharge, I explain all the medications. But reiterating is very important. That's why it is repeated. And for example, if I tell you this medication has got, I always, before prescribing, will be like, this medication has this side effect. You might or might not have it. If you do have it, please inform me so that I can take alternative medication can be given, or I can take or I can tell you what to do. So that's how it works.
Thank you, doctor.
Any way we can find it ourselves? When you go to one doctor, he wants his file. When you go to another one, he wants his file. He doesn't need to go and see the other files that you are going through. So is there any way we can find it ourselves?
You can find out drug side effects, but then it's always quite risky to actually depend on Google, because there have been lot of cases where Google can put you down completely, because there are just so many things, there's just so much information, and it might not always be right. Even if you try to find it online, you have to confirm it with your healthcare provider. And at least as far as I am concerned, in the first visit, all files are looked out. And then if at all I need, I would specifically tell you if I need any other file later. Because ultimately, it's about making a database. I mean, geriatrics is about continuum of care. It's not about one time.
Thank you, doctor.
Yeah.
Any other questions? So, doctor, thank you very much. We'll end this session today. Two or three things. This talk, it will be a recording, an audio recording of this talk will be on the Kare social website. Please feel free to have a look at it in case you want to refer to it again. I have sent you the Dr. Prem Narasimhan's, he's doing another talk today in the evening. I've sent you details on that on the Zoom chat. Please do have a look at it. Please attend that in case you'd like to. And lastly, wishing you all a very, very happy Independence Day. I hope all of us good health, and please feel free to reach out to us in case you want to talk to Dr. Prem, consult with him. We will connect you to him, and then you can directly talk to him. Having said that, thank you very much, doctor. Thank you for doing this again and again with us, and hoping to see you again next week.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you, doctor. Should we make our own database? Can we make our own
database? Own database, you mean if you want to make a database of having all the reports of your particular patient? Yeah, definitely you should. It helps.
You see, you are basing too much dependence on the doctors, healthcare, but they don't have a time to tell you the interaction and the even side effects of the medicines. And today, in the days of pandemic, if you have to call the doctor of your 10 years standing, she or he will have no time to respond to you.
How do you say this? Right. So we should make our own database and show it to the doctor. That's a better way.
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody. We'd like to log off now. In case you have any queries,
thank you so much, doctor.
Thank you, doctor.
Write to us and we'll get back to you.
Thank you, doctor.
Thank you.